Hey guys, welcome back to the Half-Life walkthrough for the PC, played on the difficult difficulty. This is the original 1998 release. I'm Big Mac Davis and this is Chapter 12, Surface Tension, the hardest and longest map in the game. Wish me luck! Alright, let's get Surface Tension started! There's a marine to your right and left when you enter this area, and you can sneak shoot them both to death with the pistol. Even if you have to aim for their feet. Now, for your own safety, it might be a good idea to blow up the barrels in this area. Yeah, the shrapnel will fall from the sky. Now have your machine gun grenades ready for this next area. Two marines who need to die. Now go back and grab the med packs if you need them, and the ammo from the dead marines. And then continue on. I hear a chopper. Fire at the gun behind the sandbag wall until it explodes. And then get out the orange gun and hold down the secondary fire button to wind up a charge and then fire at the chopper. Don't hold down the secondary fire button for too long, however, otherwise the gun will overheat and explode. Hold down the secondary fire button once again to wind up a charge and fire at the chopper. It only takes two blasts to destroy the chopper. Go across the bridge if you want to get ammo from a dead marine. But there's not much else back here, so go back across the bridge. Now in this water tank is an ichthyosaur, and the way I handle him is with the shotgun. Squeeze your way through this corner here, and try to get down as low as you can without hitting the water. I like to be at level with this black bar on the wall. Don't go any lower than that. From here, you can use the shotgun, and he typically won't be able to bite you. And he's dead? Okay, well, that makes my life easier. That saves me a lot of time. I guess the chopper must have damaged him or something. Alright, I'll take it. He's dead. Now head up the ladder on the silo area, and then press the button inside, and then use the health machine if you need to. Drop back down into the water, and then press the valve wheel. Now that button that we activated in the silo will deactivate a fan, so we can swim past it. See, that's the fan. It's now deactivated. There's an armor battery on top of this rock, so grab that if you need to. Now you can take either opening. It doesn't matter. Both will take you to the same room. And I hear another chopper. So we'll take the left path, and if you want to avoid chopper damage, you have to be kind of quick. Kill the three head crabs and get inside the cave to grab a health pack. Then go back out and head left to destroy some crates for some ammo. And then go up the ladder. Now behind you is a stash of supplies, but we'll get to that later on. Right now, we have a chopper to kill. So let's go up one more set of ladders. Now, in the cleft of this rock, you can hide and kind of get your bearings to find out where in the sky the chopper is. I like to wait until the chopper flies by to the right side. Then I wind up a charge and fire at the chopper with the orange gun again. This guy can sometimes be a pain because you're more exposed than usual, and he may be able to get a shot off on you. But one more shot from the orange gun and he should die. Alright, down he goes. High voltage. Yes, this gate is electrified. Do not touch it. To the left of it is a poor sweetness that the chopper killed for us. And a cave, so let's go through it. Now this area may seem peaceful and quiet, but it's actually a hub for several marines. What I do is I hug the right-hand wall until I can see a marine's foot to the right of this rock. Now make sure he runs to the left and make sure he does not see you. If he sees you, he will alert everybody else to your presence, and you don't want that. The second marine is hidden in the cleft of this rock to the left of the cacti. And I want to get a headshot on him, so I'll wait for him to kneel down. Just like that. The third marine is to the right of the next rock, and he's the hardest to headshot because he can see you very easily if you're not careful. The fourth and final marine is to his left, and he's the easiest. And that's all the marines. They're all dead, so grab all their ammo if you want to. And then head inside this dark cave if you want some shotgun ammo and stuff. Now, be careful. Behind two of these small crates is an active laser trip mine. So make sure it blows up before you go inside that small cave to grab the health and ammo. Alright, let's head inside the building, and we have some crossbow ammo, which we will take the time to reload the crossbow so we can use it later on. And then we'll activate the valve wheel. That will open up a hatch later on in this mission. And we're done with this section, so let's go back to the high voltage area. To the right of the high voltage sign is that stash of supplies that we skipped earlier. We're going to carefully drop down to the ledge below so we don't overshoot and fall and take damage, and then jump across. Alright, and now we'll head back up top. So there's the high voltage sign, high voltage gate. There's that cave, but to the left of the cave is where we want to go now, through this area. Now be careful as you approach this area. See that sand that rose up? There was a headcrab inside there. So, yeah, just be careful of that headcrab. There's a tentacle, like the ones in Blast Pit. You can't kill this one, however, but you can wound it enough so where it will hide in the ground. Isn't that amusing? Go along the left side of this room to circumnavigate this area to kill three more headcrabs. There's headcrab number three. And there's headcrab number 4. That's all the headcrabs in this area. Now, how do we grab the items near the tentacle? Well, we have to shoot the tentacle to get him to hide, and then we'll grab the items. But you have to be very, very quick. You won't be able to grab all the items because he'll pop right back up and hit you pretty hard, so we'll have to do this again. Alright, that's all the items we can grab. So, we'll head over to this area, on this sandbank overlooking this tentacle, just like that. So now we'll squeeze through this opening and head down here. Oh boy, mines. Yes, this valley is a minefield. It's littered with mines, so be careful. Go to the left side of the sandbank and then walk straight towards the cactus. Fire in front of the tent to blow up a landmine. You don't want to step on it. That's never a good thing. You will take massive amounts of damage. Grab the items inside the tent. Now there's that hatch that we opened up with that valve wheel. So let's go around this rock to get a better angle to jump inside. Now this ladder can be a bit fussy. You want to try and grab a hold of the ladder. Yeah, you see what I mean? Grab a hold of the ladder from underneath the top. You don't want to grab the very top. Otherwise, it will try to force you back up top. I don't know why that is, but whatever. Alright, now this area. There goes a jet fighter. And just look at this view. Look at this view. Isn't it beautiful? I think so. Have your pistol ready, and then look down and to the right, and see if you can see a Marine. And then shoot him to death. Now have your crossbow ready for a turret to the right of him, and farther up. You want to be very quick because the turret can fire on you. Carefully drop down to the ledge below. Now, to the left of this ledge and down below is another Marine you can sneak shoot with the pistol. He's very hard to spot, but it is possible. Then carefully drop down to his position. To the right of the Marine is where we want to go now. And we'll go past the dead turret, but have your crossbow ready because there's a Marine tucked away inside the rocks and you want to... Yeah, you want to kill him very, very quickly because he'll toss a grenade your way and there's nowhere to run, so you'll have to take that grenade and suffer some damage. That area was a dead end, so we'll go back past the turret to the original dead Marine. Now carefully peek over the edge and fall down to the ledge below. You will take some damage, but thankfully there's a cave here where you can grab some med packs. Turn left and once again carefully navigate your way down these ledges. Now down here, you can fall down to the skinny ledge below, but be careful to not hit the side of the cliff. If you do, it will launch you right to your death down to the valley below. So what I do is I align myself, or try to, and then jump to the thicker portion of the ledge to guarantee my safety. and there's an armor battery there. Now don't walk along the center of this bridge. It will collapse and you'll fall to your death. Rather, walk along the wire there. So, yeah, it's not that hard to do. Look underneath the silver thing over there to kill another marine. Now this next marine, around the next corner, I have a hard time sneak shooting him with the pistol, so I'll use the magnum for this guy. And there's a cave. Let's go inside. An RPG and some rockets. All right, let's grab it. And we have a chopper. A perfect opportunity to use this RPG. I wait for the chopper to pass by on my left side, and then I shoot a rocket at it. And then hide because the chopper will bomb this cave. And then once again, wait for the chopper to pass by on the left side. Awesome! Now there's some crates here we can bash. And this door is locked. Alright, so now we'll progress further. Past the cave mouth. Now this ladder, you want to be very careful and not fall off the ledge, but carefully grab a hold of the ladder. But I do like this view, by the way. It is really, really well designed. This is a very well designed room. Carefully navigate this area, these stepping stones. You can't fall through the cracks, so don't worry about that. Just jump up each one carefully, and then go up the next ladder. You know, as carefully as you can. As nerve-wracking as this area is, it is very well designed. Have your flashlight and pistol ready, because down this pipe, you want to sneak shoot a headcrab. Because he is in a position where if you just wander in the pipe, he's going to pounce at you. Now, at the path split up ahead, turn right. And in this trench, just head straight forward towards this hole. And then take the next right. Now, up here, do some peekaboo looking. Just peek your head up, alert the Marines to your presence, and then go back down, and now take the left path. Or just head straight forward. And then do the exact same thing as last time. Peekaboo! And then duck down for cover. When you do that to both sides, the Marines will get all riled up. And they will start tossing their grenades. Every which way they please. They'll damage and kill each other. Yes, that is exactly how I'm going to handle that area. There's about 5 Marines up above, and we're going to want to limit their number down to 1. To do that, they will toss grenades at each other until they all die, and they'll even destroy their own tank. I kid you not, there's a tank up there, and they will destroy it with their grenades. They're just that stupid. See, you can hear the tank has been destroyed because of the fire. The fire noise. And this is the most tedious part about this map, by the way. It's going to take about 3 or 4 minutes. But it is worth it. There's about 5 Marines up there, and there's almost no cover. So, this is the easiest way I know. But they're so stupid, they will bomb each other to death. It's a frat house. Whoa! Okay, yeah, that can sometimes happen, though not all the time. A grenade will sometimes land on top of you, on top of your position, and blow up and damage you. Hopefully it won't do it again, but most of the time it won't. So we'll just wait here for the Marines to all die. Sorry if this is somewhat boring, that's just the way, this is the easiest way I know of. I wonder if that is all of them, so I'm going to go up anyway and take a look. Quickly get your bearings and find, there he is. There's two of them. Okay, they're both dead. That wasn't too bad at all. It's better than five Marines. But see, look, their tank is destroyed. They're idiots, that's all I have to say. Behind the tank, underneath the tent, you can grab some rockets and some satchels. So grab that. And there's a health machine inside the shed. Actually, inside both sheds. Alright, so now we'll go back past the tank, and this next thing is optional what I'm going to do, but if you want another kill, go inside the trench next to this ladder. Now facing the area with the ladder, back up, and then turn right, and go inside this hole here. This hole will just take you to another opening, which will take you back up top. Normal, isn't it? Well, there will be another Marine that will spawn inside the trench. I don't know why or how he spawns there, but he just arrives, so kill him if you want another kill. But you don't have to. You can search around. Behind one of these sandbag walls is a stash of machine gun grenades, and I'm trying to find it. There it is. So grab those if you need them. And then just press the button inside the booth to open up the next door. Now in this next area, what I do is I carefully walk along the left side of these crates very carefully with the crossbow out. You want to find the darker portion of the tank right there. And fire 6 crossbow arrows at it. That will destroy the tank, so that you will not have to deal with it later on. That's the easiest way I know. Alright, let's bash open these crates. And we finally get some frag grenades. How long has it been since we haven't had any? Which, come to think of it, we're going to use the frag grenades very shortly for this hole right here. See that trench over there? Throw 5 grenades inside. 1 to the left, 1 to the right, and keep repeating until you throw 5 grenades. That should take care of all the Marines, but if it doesn't, you can throw 5 of your snarks inside that trench. Now, snarks are basically man-eating bugs, and they will search out and start eating any hostiles they come across. And then they will explode after a short period of time, like they did right now. I guess all the Marines were dead, so... Alright. So down here we have some more crates with even more items. You'll almost never run out of armor, that's for sure. At least up to this point in the game. Or this mission. Alright, we're done, so we'll go back through the hole. jump over the sandbag wall to get past the tank. Alright, through the next door. What is that thing? It dropped off a Vortigaunt! Well now, from here you can kill... Oh my gosh! Okay? That was not meant to happen. He's not supposed to see me, that alien grunt. But he did. Okay. That's okay, that... We'll improvise. We'll work around this obstacle. So the alien grunt's now dead. What you're supposed to do, you're supposed to kill the Vortigaunt, and the alien grunt is not supposed to see you until after you kill him. Then crouch down with the frag grenades, and then throw them towards his position. Two frag grenades should kill him, but he saw me, and he charged at me, but so I had to use my machine gun grenades. Oh well, don't go inside this minefield. There's nothing back there but trouble. So we'll head down to where this Vortigaunt came from. Blow up the trip mine, and by the way, all the doors in this area are locked, so don't worry about opening any of them. Now these cinder blocks can take away some suit armor, so be careful about stepping on them, or having them fall on you. Just blow up that trip mine. Now for the next trip mine, I just use my machine gun grenades, because I don't even want to deal with that on the stairs. Yeah. More cinder blocks.
Help. Help me. Somebody, please help me. I'm dying out here. Please, help me.
Poor security guard. He's dead, so don't go out to save him. There's a sniper in a nest up there. So just toss a couple frag grenades to kill him. You'll know he's dead when there's blood on the outside wall and the gun disappears. Poor security guard, I avenged your death, buddy. And just because, we'll blow up this trip mine. Another minefield, huh? Well, hug the left wall and run straight forward towards this wall, then hug this wall. And we come to, like, an obstacle course, it looks like. Oh boy. Now, there's another sniper in a nest above you, and what I do is I just try and aim my machine gun grenades up there. Well, that's... There we go. Don't do like I did and blow up the wall. Just aim for that hole there, and you should do fine. Alright, so go underneath the barbed wire, and then blow up the barrels. That will blow up the electrical box, which will stop the electricity, so you won't take damage from that. Go up the fallen down radio tower to the rooftop. Jump over the fan and find a hole in the roof. And then go inside.
You're heading for the Lambda Complex, aren't you? I was heading there myself until I wound up here and, well, simply lost my nerve. Take one look through that door and you'll see what I mean. I'm just going to wait out the catastrophe in here. If you intend to go on, then I beg of you, proceed with extreme caution.
Oh boy, thanks for the advice. Apparently, the area in the room beyond is just a catastrophe. Well, we'll see how bad it is. Let's go through the door. We have laser trip mines. Oh boy, that's what this building is all about, folks. Head inside this room for, you know, a laser trip mine of your own. One thing to note about these trip mines, do not detonate any of them. If you do, it'll set off a chain reaction and destroy the entire building and kill you. So what you have to do is carefully jump over them or avoid them. Now this next trip mine, you could walk up the railing, but sometimes it will detonate. I don't know why, but sometimes it does. So a safer way is to approach the trip mine itself, the green thing, and then jump onto it. Yeah, that's the easiest way around that one. Now do not destroy this crate. It's attached to a trip mine. And that would not be good. So jump over this one. Security is everyone's responsibility. Egag. Alright, so be careful of the head crabs over there. Just kill them. You don't want them to detonate a trip mine. Open up that crate for another trip mine if you want to, and just look at this mess. We have to navigate all this to get inside this elevator here. Oh my gosh, it's going to be a tough journey. So what we have to do, the intended route, is to squeeze through these crates, then bash through this crate carefully, do not bash the other parts of it, and then bash this crate off of this lift. And then carefully crouch under this one. Now be careful, up here is a head crab. You do not want him to detonate a trip mine. So kill him from a distance. Now, what you're supposed to do is press this button to raise up the lift. And then crouch jump onto it and be careful of the trip mine up above. What you're supposed to do is run off of this lift and jump into this lift to avoid the trip mines, but that's like a 50-50 shot of success. Not very good odds in my opinion. So what I do instead is I just jump off, go back through the crate, and then carefully jump onto this laser trip mine's green thing right there. Very carefully, then jump onto this crate, and then into the elevator. That's the safest way to navigate through this area. It's just chaotic. Press the button and ride the lift down. That was so nerve-wracking. Oh boy. What is this? Oh, it is a Hornet gun. Remember the alien grunt's Hornet gun? Well, now you have one of your own. Let's test this bad boy out. Look how powerful it is. It destroys crates in a matter of seconds. That's awesome. Now, one thing to note about the Hornet gun. If you use the primary fire button, it will launch out Hornets at a steady rate, and they'll go every which way, and they're also homing darts. If you use the secondary fire button, it will launch them at a faster speed, and they will be more direct to your aim. So keep mind of those two things, primary and secondary fire. Use the secondary fire Hornet gun when you see a Marine on the barrels. Now there's two more Marines. Okay, that was two of them. One more. If he didn't... Oh, there he is. Gee, you know what? Just suck a dick and die. Gosh. Whatever. Alright, so go back and grab the health packs if you need them. We're not going to get the security guard to follow us. He'll just be ballast to us. Alright, this truck. Be careful. Inside this truck is a turret that you want to sneak shoot. There we go. That wasn't too bad. And your reward is decent. You get some more orange gun ammo. Someone wants someone dead, that's for sure. They're really bombing this place. I guess the Marines are really starting to get angry. Alright. Crossbow ready. Let's head up the ramp. And then quickly go up this ramp, because a transport, an enemy transport, will drop down three alien grunts. Oh boy! That's the one time where the Marines come in handy. Thank you, fighter jet, for bombing the three alien grunts for us. Now carefully peek around the right corner, for you want to get your aim on another tank turret. And once again fire 6 crossbow shots at the darkened portion. And it's now destroyed. Get the orange gun ready, because we have 2 Marines. Whoa. That's so fun to do. No escaping from Big Mac Davis, that's for sure. Alright, anyway, there's nothing behind the tank, so let's just proceed down this alleyway. Well now, what are they using? Atomic bombs? I don't know. There's a sniper's nest above us, so this one can be hard to throw grenades into, but it is possible. And he's dead. Alright. Now all these doors are locked for right now. The only one that's open is, well, this one. I like to use the Magnum to try and kill the Marine inside. Carefully. When he charges at you, you do not want him to yell out. He will alert his buddy to your presence, so kill him quickly. Here's the second Marine. Oh God, no! No! Die! Oh my gosh. You don't want that to happen. You don't want this guy to go up and kill the security guard up here. We'll find out why later on, but you do not want that guard to die. That was crazy. I don't know why he was running up there. Anyway, we'll go back downstairs and bash open the crates. Phew, that was a close call. Now we'll go back up the stairs where that Marine ran to. The reason why you want to keep the security guard alive is because you want him to follow you and open up this storage room for you. Now, why was I panicking like the way I did? I guess I wasn't panicking, I was just worried. Because this is the best goddamn secret in the game. Oh my gosh, look at this. Look at how much weaponry there is. You can restock on every single weapon you have, and then some. It's like you'll never run out. That's why this secret room was so important. And that's why you want to keep that guard alive. Alright, so now we're fully stocked up. So now we'll go to the window over here, and carefully jump out. And walk along the right side of this ledge. Now, using these machines, you can jump across to get to this ladder. It's too high up to reach from the ground. And we're now on the rooftop of this building. Now, approach the jagged end of this rooftop, or basically the broken part of the rooftop, and look down to the right side. There's a Marine you can shoot at the top of his head. That's so fun to do. See all the blood go everywhere. And then head down this brown, slanty part. You want to be very quiet, and very careful. Because there's a Marine you can headshot right in the temples. So fun to do with the crossbow. I swear, the crossbow is just a wonderful weapon. A third Marine is inside this room over here, and he's hard to hit with the crossbow, because he'll run away. The Magnum seems to stun him in place. See, he doesn't want to run. So we'll just use the Magnum on him. And inside his room, there's some health packs, so grab those if you need them. And by the way, this door right here will just take you back to the alleyway, where all the doors were locked originally. Yeah, so that's one door unlocked. Now we'll go back up the slanty part of this, back to the rooftop. And now we'll take this white ledge down. And then carefully jump to the other side here. And walk along here. Alright, now this next part. See that door way off in the distance? We want to destroy that door, but not right now. We want to damage it to the point where it will explode. We will use 50 secondary fire hornets on it. 50 of them. Let's count. So that's 8. That's 16. And yeah, they will recharge, by the way. I forgot to mention that. That's 24. That's 32. If I can do my math right. That's 40. That's 48. Now just fire 2 of them. And that's 50. Now what we're going to do is run towards the door backwards. When you hear the chopper approaching, run back and then fire at the door. It's now blown up. All right. The reason why we did that, we're going to get back on the rooftop. The reason why we did that was because we wanted to release another alien grunt. Because there's 3 of them down there now. There's a... I don't even know what that's called. A helicopter with 2 propellers? I don't know. But anyway, this thing will fly around and release 2 marines at a time. And instead of us killing the alien grunts, why not have the marines do it? And by the way, yes, you can destroy this plane, or this helicopter, whatever it is. But we're going to wait until it passes about 5 revolutions. So here's the second revolution. And those Marines they kind of aimed at me. So I guess we have to duck for cover when that happens. Oh, this mission is so long, and it's hard. It's hard as hell. I'm surprised I'm doing this good so far. And we'll just keep hoping. Keep on hoping, keep on trucking. Keep on surviving. Here's the third revolution. I'm gonna duck behind here to avoid getting shot at by the Marines. Yeah, there's 3 alien grunts down below, and the 2 Marines are outnumbered. But over time, they will wear down the alien grunts, and they will eventually die. But if you can get past surface tension, you are in the clear for the rest of the game. I mean, the rest of the game is tough, but it's... I think surface tension is the toughest chapter in the game. Here comes the fourth revolution. But I hope you can find some good tactics to use against this mission, because it is really tough and really long. So I hope this walkthrough really helps. And here comes the fifth revolution, so we're going to try and destroy the plane. You can just use hornets on him, on it. It will eventually die. It actually doesn't take that many hornets to kill it. should die soon. You can try to lead the shot if you want, though it's kind of hard to do. Ah! There we go. It's destroyed. So now we'll go back where we were with that large helipad area. Now I have my orange gun ready to kill off any survivors. Okay, there was a marine. Looks like everybody's dead. Look at all the blood there. Craziness. Yeah, that's everybody dead. Wow, they took care of all three alien grunts for us. That's awesome. Let's head down this green passageway. Now, I like to wind up a charge here, because when you approach down here, you get that son of a bitch right there that you want to kill, and you're in a wide open area, so make sure to kill him quickly. These double doors take you back to the alleyway. We're going to go back and get that security guard to follow us again. Why? Because there's another supply room. But first, we're going to stock up on some ammo that we may have missed, or that we may have used up. I guess not. Oh well.
Yeah, let's go.
Have this guy follow you again, back down the stairs, and through those double doors that we just opened from the backside. He can sometimes be a tough guy to follow. There we go. Here's the secret room. It's locked. Alright, the secret room isn't as big as the other one, but it has some armor in it that the other secret room didn't have, so it's nice to have this room too. Alright, and if we go up the stairs, we'll just come to an area where there's a big gun. Now, this big gun, its main purpose is to destroy those double doors way over there, the door that we destroyed with the Hornet gun. Yeah, that's basically what it's used for, but I found a better way. So now we'll go through those doors that we blew up, next to those stop signs. And now we come to an area that's just infested with Vortigaunts. And when I mean infested, I mean over 20, I'd say. They'll spawn in only two at a time, so at least that's comforting. But what I do is I just use the primary fire button on the Hornet gun, because I don't want to use the secondary fire, because they tend to strafe. And the primary fire button will home in on the Vortigaunt, so that's a good thing. If they do that, make sure to switch to the machine gun and then use it on them if they get too close to you. And I know I do have a fast switch button, or what was it called? Last weapon used button, but I never use it. But it might come in handy for this part. You know, last weapon used was the machine gun, so press the button and it will switch right to it. Yeah, this is going to be a long, drawn-out battle. Dang. That was close. They usually don't come down this low. Now, I know I was talking with a friend of mine, and I told him about this strategy, and he said in the Source version of this game, they come down really quickly. So, but you know what? I'm not going to worry about whether or not this works for Source. I I plan on doing a Source version walkthrough of this game, but I have never played Source before. And I also plan to do Black Mesa as well, once I get a faster computer. But this is the original 1998 release, so... the tactics mentioned here in this walkthrough only work for this version, or... mainly work for this version. And they keep on coming. They're almost done, I can tell. There's only one coming in at a time. I am actually happy I haven't died yet. I'm thrilled. It's awesome. Let's see if we can continue that. And that might be all of them. Cool. We took care of them all, so without wasting any ammunition. There's some health packs and some bullets here, so grab that if you need them. You could use this gun, the stationary gun, but while you're fighting one Vortigaunt, the other ones will be pelting the ever-living hell out of you. So don't use it. It's not worth it. The Hornet gun works fine. Now this thing, I don't know what it's called, but I call it the trampoline. Yeah, original name, right? You just walk and jump on it, and it will launch you up to the next ledge. They're kind of fun to play with. Approach this ledge and then back up. That will start an infight to happen. It's an infight between several Marines, an alien grunt, a Vortigaunt, and five snarks. Believe it or not. Yeah, they're down there. And I guess the fight's over. Yeah, you can hear the snarks blowing up. You're dead? Now where's that Vortigaunt? Maybe he died. Okay, well, to get that top med pack on that crate, you have to run and jump off of this. But I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to run and jump onto this one, because it's hard to get up top there. To get onto these crates from the bottom floor, you have to jump from the cement block to here. So you can't jump on the top crate. Okay, so we're down here. Everything's taken care of. This vent grating will be opened up, and there will be five snarks that will come out. Those are the snarks I mentioned before. So let's go through this vent opening. And see how that vent opening is kind of broken? Shoot at it to break it open. Now be careful. Run for cover behind these crates, because a few more snarks will be revealed. And they are man-eating bugs, and they will attack you. They don't do much damage, but, you know. And like I said before, they will explode after a short period of time. So. I think that's all of them. So let's go back through. We have 15 snarks, but we can only carry 15 at a time, so we have 15. That's kind of cool how they're already starting to build their nests in these vents. Scary. Bash open this grate, but back up quickly. And then just watch and listen. Oh, I swear, that is so therapeutic to see those bugs eat the Marines. Oh my gosh. Then you can go back and stock up on 10 more. Oh, that's so awesome. Alright, so to avoid taking damage from the fall on the back bumper of the car. And then grab the armor batteries. And there's a health machine over here. Okay, so open this door, but be very careful. Back away quickly and hide in the corner. Then the wall will blow up. And then from here, you can toss out 10 snarks. Just jump and toss them to make sure they go over. And they will eat the Marines. And I know one of them actually didn't go over. Yeah, there he is. See how he's chasing me? See how the sweetness is chasing me? Wait a minute. They didn't eat any of the Marines. Maybe they died. Okay, I will assume they're dead. I hope they're dead. Now, the left switch right here will just lower down this car. That's not what we want to do. So, we'll use the right switch to lower down this thing. This jack, I guess. And then press it again to ride it back up. And then run out of the hole. Alright, and we're out in this area. What? That's not supposed to be blown open. And there's an alien grunt right there. Okay, so... what we're gonna have to do is run for the gun and then just fire at the alien grunt. Fire, and then, there will be 4 alien grunts total. There's 2. There's 3. Well, I guess I killed 4 of them already. Maybe one of them already died. This is confusing, but whatever. I guess the Marines must have blown up that door with one of their grenades. That's the only way I can think of. Anyway, we'll move on. Use your secondary fire Hornet gun to blow up that, or to kill that Vortigaunt. Well, this mission's so long, it's making my commentary suffer. So I apologize. Just do what I do and you should be fine. I know, that's kind of cheating, but you can use your secondary fire orange gun to fire through a wall, and you can actually kill the enemy behind it, see? I don't know if it's cheating, but it is kind of fun to do. Alright, that looks to be everybody dead. There were some alien grunts and some Marines down here, but they're all dead now. Alright, so... Whoa! Oh, you're there. You were hiding. Okay, so... Now that looks to be everybody dead. I hope. So head inside this storage room, and you can grab some more items from here. And make sure to squeeze inside this metal crate to grab some orange gun ammo. Alright, so with everybody dead and everything collected, we'll go back up the ladder. Now to cross this area, what I do is I just jump onto the railing and jump across. Turn left and you can get a health machine. Alright, now approach this next area very slowly because you'll see. Yeah, a Marine gets thrown through the wall, and there's an alien grunt around that corner that you want to carefully peek around the corner and sneak shoot him with the crossbow. It takes 3 shots to kill him. There he is. He got tripped up by my arrow. Okay, so he's taken care of. Now, there's a hole right here. And equip your hornets, and then just use the primary fire button. That will send the arrows forward and will make them home in on two marines down below. And just keep doing it till both marines are dead. Now, once they start dancing around like that, that means there's no more hostiles for them to find, so... quickly shoot down this alien grunt, because he will kill the marine faster than the marine will kill him. Okay, we're gonna use the crossbow then, if you don't want to cooperate. Just die. And he's dead. And we'll headshot this marine. Just because his back is turned, and what the hell was he doing not helping his buddy out with that alien grunt? Well, whatever. Alright, so we'll drop down the hole very carefully. Make sure to destroy that big crate. For some reason, when you drop next to it, it will damage you. I don't know the reason behind it, but make sure to destroy it before you drop down. Alright, so now we're in this area. There's a alleyway right here that we can go down, and we haven't used the shotgun for a while. It hasn't gotten to see some love, so we'll use it on that Vortigaunt. And there's an alien grunt on the rooftop up there, so... he has a pattern. He will walk to the left, then walk to the right, and back and forth. So, just aim at a certain spot where you know he stands still, and then just fire when he crosses that path. And he's dead. Simple as that. Now, up the ramp, there's not much up here for the time being. It just takes you to a dark passageway with a door that is locked. So we'll have to come back later. Let's head back down the ramp and continue forward. We come to this security booth. And we can grab a shotgun from that shelf there. And this door is also locked, so we'll have to come back later on. The only thing left to do is use this trampoline to get up to the next ledge, or the rooftop above, where that marine was very, very stupid. You know what? I'm going to take your ammo, marine. You don't deserve to die with it. Bash open this grating and jump through. Alright, now this section's tricky. Very tricky. Squeeze through this hole. Now, have your crossbow ready and zoomed in. See, this is a hatch door, and there's the center of it, about right there. You want to aim just to the right of the center of the hatch, and keep focus there. When it opens, fire. You'll get the headshot. That's a bomb! Go back out before it explodes, then duck down in this corner. The bomb will explode no matter what you do, and you want to avoid the hot flames that come out of the pipe. Because it will take away a lot of your suit armor if you're not careful. This is another area where more marines will infight, this time with some headcrabs. Guess they're all... nope, they're still alive. Okay, well, he's dead. I took care of them for you, head crabs. Stupid little guy. No, where's the head crab going, sweetness? Well, he's dead. Wonder if there's a marine. Nope, okay, they're all dead. Good. Because they have machine gun grenades, and they can use them on you. Not cool. Alright, so it looks like everybody is in fact dead, so we'll use the health machine if we need to. And then go back up the ladder. Now up here, jump onto this skinny pipe, and then open up the hatch. And then crawl through to the next area. This mission's almost over. We're getting closer, but I'm not going to jinx it just yet. I haven't died, but don't want to jinx it just yet. So, in this area, have your Magnum ready, because just to the right, you can kind of sneak shoot a Marine. And you want to make sure he dies quickly. There we go. That's much better than the other Marine that ran up the stairs. Now, behind these shelves over here is another Marine, but this one will always be stationary if you sneak shoot him, so he's easy. I kinda missed there with the second shot, but that's okay. Use the health machine if you need to. And this door is locked, so we'll have to come back later on. Go up the stairs to the very top.
Stand back. Hello.
Phew. Well, Barney, you recognized me.
Okay.
Come follow me.
We work together.
Come follow me down to the bottom of the stairs and unlock the door for me. This security guard is crucial to progressing in this map. You can't finish this map without him, so make sure he lives. Alright, leave the security guard here. Because you want to venture forward by yourself. And we're back in this area again, by the way. And there's a Vortigaunt down there. And he ran off, so I guess he'll use the shotgun. Why not? There he is. This Vortigaunt can be a real troublemaker for your security guard. You don't want the security guard to die. Because now we have to go back and get the security guard to follow us again.
I'd like to get my hands on the guy responsible for this mess.
I'm the man responsible for this mess.
Stand a better chance if you team up.
And have the security guard follow you all the way back to that security booth, you know, with the shotgun. If the security guard dies, that's right, you can't progress in this map. So make sure he doesn't die. Now, this next section is probably the most dangerous section in this map. Let's get our security guard to follow us again. I hope I don't die. I've died every time in a practice run. So, here goes nothing. There's a gargantua. That's pretty looking, isn't it? Alright, he will kill your security guard, buddy. But that's okay, he's of no use to us anymore. Run! Run! Don't stop running until you get to right here at this corner. Then run. Once he flips over that car. Don't shoot at me, don't shoot at me, don't shoot at me, don't shoot at me. Just run, don't look back, just keep running. And then use this trampoline to get into the water here. As fast as your legs can carry you. And then carefully climb up this pipe to the top. Forget about Freeman, huh? Well, they forgot about us then. The gargantua is released, so we have to use this tactical map to bomb him. See the colored squares there? That is your target. And that is the gate right there, so we have to raise it up a little bit and then bring it to the right to hover over the gate that he broke through. About right there. And then airstrike him. And then press it again. Oh, he blew up. Thank the Lord he blew up! Sometimes he will run out of the gate and just... he will fire at you and you'll die. There's just no escaping it. Oh, my gosh, I can't believe I did it without dying. I just... wow. On a recording, too. Thank the Lord. Now we have to destroy that door over there. So to do that, we have to use the tactical map to raise the colored squares to the top, and then to the top left. Just a little bit. See, the door has now been destroyed. Now we have to destroy that wall right there. To do that, we have to bring the target a little bit to the right, about right there, and then bomb it. Alright. Now we have to destroy this radio tower by destroying the two green boxes there. To do that, we'll have to bring the tactical map reader a little bit to the right again. About right there, I'd say. Now, sometimes you have to use the airstrike more than once. Wow, in this case, three times. There we go. See how it's fallen over? That will allow us to get to that door. Now, one thing you have to note here, you will die if you're not fast enough. Once you cross over the radio tower, you have to run very quickly. Run! Don't stop running! See, I took some damage even though I ran fast. They're starting the airstrikes above us. They're just bombing the hell out of Black Mesa. So, just run. We're done! With surface tension. Oh my gosh. Something like 25 to 30 practice runs. I kid you not, I practiced this map that many times. I had to invent the best strategies. Oh my gosh. And I did it without dying. Thank you for watching. I will see you in Forget About Freeman in the next video. I'm Big Mac Davis. Take care, everybody. Oh my gosh.